has come to our family. You remember our venerable house? Opulent and imperial, gazing proudly from its stoic perch above the moor. I lived all my years in that ancient, rumor-shadowed manor, fattened by decadence and luxury. And yet I began to tire of conventional extravagance. Singular, unsettling tales suggested the mansion itself was a gateway to some fabulous and unnameable power. With relic and ritual, I bent every effort towards the excavation and recovery of those long-buried secrets, exhausting what remained of our family fortune on swarthy workmen and sturdy shovels. At last, in the salt-soaked crags beneath the lowest foundations, we unearthed that damnable portal of antediluvian evil. Our every step unsettled the ancient earth, but we were in a realm of death and madness. In the end, I alone fled laughing and wailing through those blackened arcades of antiquity, until consciousness failed me. You remember our venerable house, opulent and imperial. It is a festering abomination. I beg you, return home, claim your birthright, and deliver our family from the ravenous, clutching shadows of the darkest dungeon.
Okay, so, hello YouTube and all of my one subscribers. This is Templar Foxy here, and I am going to be doing a Let's Play of Darkest Dungeon. This is, without a doubt, one of my favorite games, and, well, you saw from the intro trailer, this is going to be a little interesting. I really love this game's art style, the way the combat works, and just its amazing art. I'm sure you can see my original save file up there. I'm going to be starting a new one for the Let's Play, so...
You will arrive along the old road. It winds with a troubling, serpent-like suggestion through the corrupted countryside, leading only, I fear, to ever more tenebrous places. There is a sickness in the ancient, pitted cobbles of the old road, and on its writhing path, you will face viciousness, violence, and perhaps other damnably transcendent terrors. So steel yourself, and remember there can be no bravery without madness. The old road will take you to hell, but in that gaping abyss, we will find our redemption.
So that was the opening cutscene to the actual game, in which your carriage sort of crashes, and now, for the tutorial, we have to survive getting off of the old road. So. Oh, this door's. Oh. God damn it. Give me a moment. That was stupid. My family bothered me. Alright. So, here we have Reynold the Crusader there. One of my favorite characters. And Dismas the Highwayman. And we have.
Brigands have
here.
Run up these lanes. Keep to the side path. The hamlet is just ahead.
So, I'm sure you noticed below the character HP there is a little bar of squares. Yes, that is your stress meter. If that bar fills up entirely, your character will go insane in various ways, and it can actually fill up a second time. If it fills up a second time, your character will have a heart attack and die. And the way this game works is if your characters die, they're dead. You don't get them back.
Dispatch this thug in brutal fashion, that all may hear of your arrival.
So, here we now have our first enemy.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Obviously, the combat is turn-based, right? That's pretty obvious. Here we have our first.
Leave nothing unchecked. There is much to be found in forgotten places.
Now, it's not to all my real food to heal, because now we're going to essentially get a tutorial boss fight.
An ambush. Send these vermin a message. The rightful owner has returned, and their kind is no longer welcome.
So, the enemy's party composition is obviously pretty simple. Big tanky guy in the front, and you have a DPS shoot people guy in the back. Who I am going to shoot myself.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Now, obviously, these are like corpses. You're trying to screw with the enemy party composition, and if a dead person leaves a corpse, you will have to get rid of the corpse if you're still intent on damaging their party composition. But the moment that's not really the problem, because we're just supposed to function in their current positions, even though it has been going bad. So obviously the enemy is also capable of messing up your party comp and putting characters where you don't.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
It's pretty basic. Completed the quest. Now, I'll remain and show you this treasure chest, which quite obviously says a bandage trapped chest. It's going to, you know, do that. That's just to essentially show you that not everything is going to be trustworthy and the interactables can harm you. And so, now we finish the quest. Now, as you can see, Rainbow Plus must have gotten some perks. Or quirks, rather, as the game refers to them. They're pretty simple. They're essentially just character traits. Some
Welcome
of them
home,
will be very good and
such
some
as
of
it
them
is.
Will be bad.
This squalid hamlet, these corrupted lands, they are yours now. And you are bound to them.
Now, here we have the hamlet, which is essentially your normal hub area, I guess you could call it. Which is where you hire adventurers, upgrade them, give them stress relief, and whatnot. Now, For the moment, we can't really access.
Most will end up here, covered in the poisoned earth, awaiting merciful oblivion.
Is recruit two new heroes.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
So here we have Brickville, the plague.
Women and men, soldiers and outlaws, fools and corpses.
This does a lot of poisoning.
All will find their way to us now that the road is clear.
And Questraham, the Vestalt, which is essentially just a cleric.
A mecca of madness and morbidity. Your work begins.
So you have to combine your characters down there in the bar into a party. And so, this is the pretty basic party composition of the Crusader, Highwayman, Plague Doctor, and Vestalt. And so, we're going to go into this level 1 dungeon, in which we need simply explore 90% of the rooms.
The cost of preparedness, measured now in gold, later in blood.
Torches, and very, very important for some reason, shovels. You'll see why if the quest deigns to give us the need for a shovel. So obviously now we have this entire map of the dungeon, which we have to explore 90% of it. Brickville, you're very eager to kill things, aren't you? Oh, no, what button am I trying to press? There we go. Necromania, let's see, fascinated with corpses. Yeah, you want things to die. However, you're good at healing and you have Warrior of Light. What are your good skills? Plague, grenade, lightning, gas, battlefield medicine, and disorienting blast. All good. You have Divine Grace, Illumination, Hand of Light, and Mace Smash. You, honestly, I will need to unlock you some new skills, Questraham, because about the only thing you can use in your current position is the Divine Grace. So, obviously, you can only use certain abilities in certain positions of the party, so there are places where it would be best to put your character. Oh, you have Quantumania, don't you? Or Curious, whatever. Basically, Questraham will interact with things without me telling her to. Which could be good, or it could be very bad. Well, we have a first fight. Pretty normal. Now, as you can see, I have surprised the foe, which means that they're somewhat freaked out, and they will not be able to take their turn until the entirety of my party has taken theirs. Meaning that we can essentially just murder them. You know, you can't do much. I'm definitely going to have to switch your skills around. Rain will finish them.
Another abomination cleansed from our lands. Wealth beyond measure, awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
So, the crests are essentially this form of secondary currency from gold. You have to use them to unlock things. They're all, or well, maybe not currency, but a material. Now, since our party has successfully scouted things, we know a bit of what's coming up in the dungeon. There's a room with some treasure in it, and a room with essentially a sort of blessing that you can use. However, it looks like upcoming, there is the reason why I said it's a good idea to take a shovel.
Even
and
the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
If you don't have a shovel, that removing that blockage will harm your entire party and damage your light level. Which, the light level you can see above is the torch. Now, that cultist over there deals stress to the party, making her the bitch, so I'm going to try and murder her. However, that critical heal may have just fixed it. I'm no longer going to swing at the cultist, because now that she's poisoned, she will die on her next turn. Torchlight, your party is more likely to be surprised, which essentially means the entire enemy party gets to take their turn before you have any chance to swing. It may also screw up your party composition.
As the light gains purchase,
however,
spirits
for
are
some
lifted,
reason at lower light
and
levels,
purpose is made clear.
Your characters have a higher chance to critical hit, and also will find more loot. However, it's more dangerous.
Decisive pummeling.
Right.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Gator doesn't like Dismas much, does it?
Grievous injury.
Ow.
Palpable fear. Give them no quarter.
Oh, yep. That hurts.
confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Oh. Healing and a massive stress heal. That was very good. So, certain interactables you may wish to use certain items with them. Like, for example, anything that has to do with holy, generally it's best to pour a holy water on it. Oh no.
If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
God damn it, Reynold's a kleptomaniac. So that means he will not only interact with things without telling me, like Questraham over here, he'll also take things without my discretion.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
Oh. I could leave, but that is treasure, and we are not hurting.
In Radiance, may we find victory.
Right. Another fight. Oh, a full enemy party call. Uh-oh. Alright. Good job, Dismas.
Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken.
Now, final action. Now we are done.
A great horror beneath the manor. A crawling chaos that must be destroyed.
The tavern is now usable and the abbey is now usable. which... I am going to hire Buron.
The raw strength of youth may be spent, but his eyes hold the secrets of 100 campaigns. Have been dusted, the pews set straight. The abbey calls to the faithful.
And now, I think I shall upgrade my stagecoach in order to have a large number of heroes.
Word is traveling. Ambition is stirring in distant cities.
Because, you know,
we can use this. Pace out the halls of your lineage once familiar. Now, Buron.
Now, let's go left first. Just because this is an easy route to grab so I can finish the quest earlier. You do not want to spend more time than necessary within the dungeon, as you will pay as you may perish.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Oh, that's not good.
Precision.
Oh, Dismas. I think you're an MVP. Oh, you're perfect. Okay. Perishing
Fidel. Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. Fiend falls, a
faint hope blossoms. Wealth beyond measure, awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
And yet again, as I have said,
even the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
Bring shovels. It's a good idea. Ah, skeletons. Oh, and they're faster than us. That's not good. That's not good.
Another one falls.
Come on, Randall.
Another abomination cleansed from our lands.
Well, that's not much. Treasure. Yes, Randall, you kleptomaniac. It is indeed an accident. Let's just head over to this over here, shall we? Grab a torch.
If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
Enemies. Ah, bandits.
Is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Oh, that blanket fire is gonna get me. God damn it. Questram, why couldn't you come with your AoE heal? I'm blaming Questram.
Your confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Up in here, you can't really do much. I say as they shoot Reynold. Now I was one of Commander Arm's abilities in which he has
this advantage.
Reynold.
Give them no quarter.
Oh, this is a
hellish horrors, brought low and driven into the mud.
Equestrian one here would have come with the Vestal's AoE heal, which is probably going to be the first thing that I purchase for her when I am able to mess around with their skill abilities. Unfortunately, it is looking like someone may die here. Always fine. Alright, I'm going to try to not immediately kill them. Oh, there we go. Just so that we can get at least one heal.
Be gone, fiend. Executed with impunity. A trifling victory, but a victory nonetheless.
No,
clarified
bad.
In a single strike.
I know how Dust Storm works. Heal. Now then. This one doesn't die.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
I'm feeling the pain a bit more than I did in my Radiant playthrough. This is most certainly harder. Never got this bad levels. Which means that, you know, probably die more. I would like to think that I'm a good player at this game, but I'm only really saying that because I've never gotten a party wiped. But now that I've said that, I probably will get a party wiped. Jesus, those assholes are just so fast. No, don't do it.
victories mount, so too will resistance.
Always, I would like to read this. Journals of Darius Highwayman 306. Day 6. As we traveled from the hamlet, an eerie dread grew. We all felt it, but did our best to shrug it off. Sleep was difficult until Raven, one of my companions, passed me a bitter concoction. The most devout of us, Therion, prayed softly for our safety, superstitious but well intention, I suppose. I am already falling asleep. Okay. That's interesting. What's in you? Ooh, I like treasure. Yes, I do. I like treasure. How about you? Alright. Party's hurting a bit, so I think I'm just gonna leave.
The great ruins belong to us. And we will find whatever secrets they hold. You answered the letter. Now, like me, you are a part of this place.
Yes. Who?
A sister of battle, pious and unrelenting.
Now.
Make no mistake, we will face ever greater threats. Our soldiers must be ready.
Poison.
Corruption has soaked the soil, sapping all good life from these groves. Let us burn out this evil. Trinkets and baubles, paid for in blood.
Now, seeing as we don't know what's in this room, and we have to leave any room that has any.
If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
Well, what is it with you and missing your first shot? Is this? See? Rick landed a hit.
Oh,
system is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Now, party in.
Is the weapon that cuts on its own. Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. Finding the stuff is only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
Oh, well, for some. No matter, we had to check anyways.
Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken. Decisive pummeling. The slow death, unforeseen, unforgiving. How quickly the tide turns.
Has to be a room battle somewhere, because if there weren't
the light,
any, the quest
the promise
would be
of safety
on me entering the dungeon. Oh, yep, speak of the devil.
precision and power. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. Give them no quarter. Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all. Wealth beyond measure. Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike. Laden with loot, are often low on supplies.
Another page.
Nature herself, a victim to the spreading corruption, malformed with misintent. The way is lit, the path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
Oh, spiders. Poor spiders. Oh.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Thank you.
gone, fiend.
Yep, indeed.
Another abomination cleansed from our lands.
Driving out corruption is an endless battle. But one that must be fought.
Rusts, in my opinion, will be the most common of these materials you